Hello students, today we will continue chapter factors and multiples. We will continue the chapter topic least common multiple. LCM of two or more numbers is the least common multiple of these numbers. Students, there are three methods of finding LCM as we discussed in our previous video. We already discussed its two methods, first by listing multiples. Second, prime factorization method. In today's video, we will discuss its third method, common division method. We will discuss this common division method by taking an example. Let us find the LCM of 30, 45 and 60 by common division method. In first step, we have to write the numbers in a line separately by commas. 30, 45, 60. Now, in next step, divide the numbers by the common prime factors of one or more numbers. Here, 30 is divisible by the prime number 2. We are getting here 15. 45 is not divisible by the prime number 2. We have to write it as it is. 60 is divisible by the prime number 2. We are getting here 30. Now, we have to repeat the same process of division. In next step, 15 is not divisible by the prime number 2. We have to write it as it is. And 45 is not divisible by the prime number 2. We have to write it as it is. 30 is divisible by the prime number 2. We are getting here 15. Now, in next step, 15 is divisible by the prime number 3. We are getting here 5. 45 is divisible by the prime number 3. We are getting here 15. 15 is divisible by the prime number 3. We are getting here 5. Now, in next step, 5 is not divisible by the prime number 3. We have to write it as it is. 15 is divisible by the prime number 3. We are getting here 5. 5 is not divisible by the prime number 3. We have to write it as it is. Now, in next step, 5 is divisible by the prime number 5. We are getting here 1. 5 is divisible by the prime number 5. We are getting here again 1. And then 5 is divisible by the prime number 5. We are getting here 1. And now, we have to stop because all quotients equal to 1. Now, LCM is equal to 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 3 multiply by 3 multiply by 5 and this is equal to 180. So the LCM of the given number 30, 45 and 60 by common division method is equal to 180. Now let us discuss other example. Find the smallest number which when divided by 25, 40, 60 leaves remainder 7 in each case. In this solution, let us first, we have to find the LCM of these three given numbers. We have to write these numbers in a line separated by commas. 25, 40, 60. Now divide the numbers by the common prime factors of one or more numbers. Now we can see here 25 is not divisible by the prime number 2, so we have to write it as it is. And now 40 is divisible by the prime number 2. We are getting here 20. 60 is divisible by the prime number 2, we are getting here 30. Now, we have to repeat the same process of division. In next step, 25 is not divisible by the prime number 2, we have to write it as it is. 20 is divisible by the prime number 2 and we are getting here 10. 30 is divisible by the prime number 2, we are getting here 15. Now we have to repeat the same process of division. 25 is not divisible by the prime number 2, we have to write it as it is. 10 is divisible by the prime number 2, we are getting here 5. 15 is not divisible by the prime number 2, we have to write it as it is. Now, in next step, 25 is not divisible by the prime number 3, we have to write it as it is. 5 is not divisible by the prime number 3, we have to write it as it is. 15 is divisible by the prime number 3, we are getting here 5. Now, in next step, 25 is divisible by the prime number 5, we are getting here 5. 5 is divisible by the prime number 5, we are getting here 1. Again, 5 is divisible by the prime number 5, we are getting here 1. And now, in next step, 5 is divisible by the prime number 5, we are getting here 1. Now, we have to stop when we are getting all quotient equals to 1. Now, LCM is equal to 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 3 multiply by 5 multiply by 5. This is equal to 600. Therefore, the required number is equal to 600 plus 7 and is equal to 607. Now, let us check this. First, we will take 607 as dividend and 25 as divisor. 25 twos are 50 and the difference is 10. Now we have to move down the next digit of dividend, that is 7, and the number is 107. Now 25 fours are 100 and the difference of 107 and 100 is equal to 7. Now we have to check other number. We will take 607 as dividend, 40 as a divisor. 40 ones are 40 and the difference of 60 and 40 is 20, and we have to move down the next digit of dividend, that is 7. The number is 207. Now, 45s are 200 and the difference of 207 and 200 is 7. Now, we have to check other number. We will take 607 as dividend and 60 as a divisor. 60 ones are 60. The difference of 60 and 60 is 0. We have to move down the other digit of dividend, that is 7. 60 multiply by 0, we are getting here 0. The difference of 7 and 0 is equal to 7. We can see here, in all cases, the remainder is 7. Now, moving towards home assignment. Thank you.